गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी डू सम मोर एग्जांपल्स एज वेल एज क्वेश्चंस आफ्टर टेलिंग यू द कंसेप्ट ऑफ प्राइम फैक्टर्स एच सी एफ एंड एलसीएम एंड सो ऑन. सो लेट मी टेक वन इम्पॉर्टेंट एग्जांपल, एग्जांपल नंबर फाइव, पेज नंबर नाइन. Question says, consider 4 to the power n, where n is a natural number. And we are told to check whether 4 to the power n ends with digit 0. When you read that, you will get confused and you will think that what we have to do in this question. So don't worry about this. Try to understand the meaning. 4 to the power n ends with the digit 0. It means, what is n? If you want to take some example and then you can simply understand, it will be easy. N is a natural number. Take n equal to 1. 4 to the power 1. I want to use some rough work, student, for telling you. 4 to the power n, if you will put n equal to 1, 4 to the power 1, does it end with 0? No. 4 to the power 2, does it end with 0? No, it ending on 6. 4 to the power 3, does it end with 0? No, it ends with a 4. Now, similar, we have to check whether 4 to the power n ends with the digit 0. So by taking many examples we can prove, but this is not the right method. We have to go by just to use a fundamental method. How we can use the fundamental theorem of arithmetic as well as the prime factorization here to check 4 to the power n ends with digit 0 or not. So this method is a bit different. Here we use the contradiction method. Hope you have heard this in class 9th. In contradiction method, whatever we have to show, we will take or assume its opposite. In the contradiction method, whatever we have to check or we have to show, we usually take its opposite. We assume its opposite. It means we will assume that 4 to the power n will end at 0. Let, very important consideration, let 4 to the power n ends with digit 0. It is not fact. It is just assumption, and we assume that 4 to the power n ends with 0. When you saw these example, we are assured that 4 to the power n will never end at 0. If we'll go with 4 to the power 4, if we'll go with 4 to the power 5, whatever, as many examples if you'll take, it will never end at the digit 0. It will never end at the digit 0. We know it. But how to show? So we consider that 4 to the power n ends with the digit 0. And student, very simple thing you should know that. Consider all those numbers which ends at 0. All those numbers which ends at 0. 5 is always one of the prime factor of this. 5 is always one of the prime factor of all those numbers which ends with the digit 0. Meaning 5 is 5 divides 50, 5 divides 30. I mean to say, for all those numbers which ends with digit 0, 5 is always a prime factor. Look student, what you assumed. Let 4 to the power n ends with the digit 0. It is a contradiction method. The method follows. Just assume the opposite, whatever you have to show. 4 to the power n ends with 0, we assume. Therefore, what I'm writing, 5 will be one of its prime factor. It is nothing a special word, very simple word I'm writing. When you have assumed that 4 to the power n ends with 0, it means whatever the number 4 to the power n is, definitely carry a 5 as the prime factor. I repeat my sentence. You assume that 4 to the power n ends with 0, and you know that those numbers which ends with 0, definitely 5 will be one of its factor, prime factor. I have taught you here that 50 is divisible by 5 because it is ending at a 0, meaning 5 is one of its factor. 4 to the power n, you consider that it ends with 0, meaning 5 will be one of the factor. Okay. Now, since 4 to the power n, the meaning of 4 to the power n is 2 into 2. 4 to the power n, it meaning 2 to the power 2n. 2n. What this line says, 4 to the power n can be written 2 to the power 2n, meaning all its prime factor is 2. Not still got. Let me explain. Suppose 4 to the power n is your 3. 4 to the power n is your 3. 4 can be written 2 to the power 2 to the power 3. This is 3. 3 2s are 6. What its meaning? 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. All prime factors are only 2. All prime factors are only 2. Does it contain 5? No. I would write that since 4 to the power n will be 2 to the power 2n, meaning 4 to the power n contains all 2 as prime factor. Now, student, think about this sentence and this sentence. 5 will be one of its prime factor. You wrote there, you assume there. Here you are writing to 4 to the power n having 2 as only prime factor, not 5, which is contradiction. What is the meaning of contradiction? The contradiction meaning that whatever you assumed, we are getting its opposite result. Whatever you assumed, you are getting its opposite result. And when 2 is the prime factor, which is contradiction, hence, whatever you assumed, you have to make it correct. Student, I know that this is a tough method, but you have to follow this in the habit. I would begin again for you. What we have to check whether 4 to the power ends with digit 0. We know that for all the natural number, 4 to the power n never end with 0. We know it. We saw some examples also in rough work. But this is a contradiction method. In that method, we will assume its opposite. Let 4 to the power ends with digit 0. We know 4 to the power n will never end with 0. Still we take 4 to the power n ends with digit 0. We know that we are wrong. So how to prove we are wrong? 4 to the power n ends with digit 0. That's a true we assume. Now, therefore, 5 will be one of its prime factors. We know that those number end with 0, 5 will be one of its factor. I stop here. Now I took 4 to the power n. I have shown here that it is 2 to the power 2n. And the meaning of 2 to the power 2n meaning all its prime is 2. 4 to the power n having all the 2 as a prime factor. Well, you wrote 5 is one of the prime factor. Now you are writing 2 as all is a prime factor, which is a contradiction. It is wrong. And hence, remove this contradiction. Meaning, you are removing your assumption. 4 to the power n. Now, write this sentence correct. 4 to the power n never end with digit 0. And that's over the question. So, students, I know it's a bit tough, but I told that you have to follow this in the practice. If you are still confused, I want to take one more question. Exam question number 5. पेज नंबर 11 ऑफ द बुक. क्वेश्चन सेम, क्वेश्चन इज सेम. चेक वेदर 6 to the power n एंड विथ डिजिट 0 फॉर ऑल n इज अ नेचुरल नंबर. सो आई वुड राइट वेरी सिमिलर. नाउ स्टूडेंट, इफ यू डिड नॉट गेट हियर, ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड बाय वॉचिंग दीज टू पैरेलल. I know that 6 to the power n will never end with 0. 6 to the power n will never end with 0. Like 6 to the power 1 is 6. It does not end with 0. 6 to the power 2 is 36. It does not end with 0. 6 to the power 3 is 216. It does not end with 0. We know that 6 to the power n will never end with 0. But still, we let. It is a contradiction method. 6 to the power n ends with digit 0. What we assume? 6 to the power n ends with digit 0. And finally, we have to conclude it is wrong. How it is? We'll tell you. Just see them parallel. When 4 to the power n ends with 0, what we conclude? 5 is one of the prime factor. When 6 to the power n end with 0, meaning 5 will be one of its prime factor. Now, since same word, 6 to the power n will be. So, it was 4 to the power n, I wrote 2 to the power 2 to the power n, then 2 to the power 2n, but this time please don't write same. 6 cannot be written like that, but 6 can be written 2 into 3 to the power n, meaning 2 to the power n and 3 to the power n. It meaning all the primes are 2 and 3. Therefore, we would write that 6 to the power n contains all primes as 2 and 3. Or 2 and 3 as a prime factor of 6 to the power n, you can use your terminology, no matter at all. So what prime factors we are using? 2 and 3. And what you wrote here, 5 will be one of its prime factor. And you are writing that 6 to the power n having only 2 prime factors, 2 and 3, which is contradiction. And lastly, you would write same sentence, hence remove this contradiction. Six to the power n never and with digit 0. So hope by these two examples you understood that what kind of that question. Now I would again explain the LCM and HCF of two numbers, because in your book very few questions it was, which was also simple. So I want to tell you one question. That find the extra question I am telling you. Find the HCF and LCM of 30, 32 and 500. Suppose this is a question. So how to do this question? Let me explain. By prime factorization method, first you have to take 30 and you have to factorize that. By factorization method, 30, you know that it's very simple, 2, 3 and 5. Now what about 32? You should know 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 5 times. And lastly, 500. So 500 meaning it is 250, 2, 125, 5 into 5 into 5. In short, I would write 2 to the power 2 and 5 to the power 3. And now see these factors. Don't focus on that one, because already we have changed in the index form. Now I would first find what is HCF. So I have taught you, for finding HCF, you have to search the common things, the common prime factor in all. See, 2 and 2, which is the common in all. Now see having the least power of that common prime factor. 2 is a common prime factor having least power 2 to the power 1, 2 to the power 5, 2 to the power 2. Least power with 2 to the power 1, meaning 2, is the HCF of 30, 32 and 500. Focus and concern the thing that it should be common in all. The number should common in all. That will be your HCF. If no element, no factor is common in all, always HCF will be 1. Now, we find LCM. For finding LCM, first see which one is a common prime factor in all. 2, 2 and 2 is a common. Take its highest power. 2 to the power 1, 2 to the power 5, 2 to the power 2. Meaning 2 to the power 5 will be one of the part of LCM. The answer is still remaining. What next? First I took common. Have written with the maximum power. Now see the next factor. It is a 3. And we don't have 3 anywhere. See this, this and this. 3 is only here. 3 is not here. 3 is not here. This the part of the LCM. Now see 5. 5 is here. And 5 is also here. Even 5 is not here. Still we have to write with its maximum power. So this is speciality of LCM. Just before the day when I taught you this LCM and HCF, this kind of example did not come. That's why I took this example for understanding you that 5 is common in only 2 factors, but as far as the LCM is concerned, you have to take with its maximum power, meaning 5 to the power 3 is its maximum, 5 to the power 1 here least, 5 to the power 3 you have to take. And lastly, I would say it is 32 and it is 125. Do their multiplication by your own. Please do its self work. I have written here. This will be your answer. So hope student, you got till here. So I have explained here the 3 question. Lastly, in simple word, I would tell you the question number 7 of exercise 1.2. It seems also good. Now read by yourself. I'm not writing that. Last question, 7th question says, there is a circular path around a sports field. Sonia takes 18 minutes to drive one round of the field, while Ravi takes 12 minutes for same. Suppose they both start at the same point and at the same time and go in the same direction. After how many times or minutes will they meet it again at the starting point? So it means that Sonia takes 18 minutes and Ravi takes 12 minutes. And definitely in circular path, when they start in this direction, both Sonia and Ravi, what they are saying that they're completing one circular path in 18 minutes and Ravi takes one circular, Ravi takes 12 minutes for one circular path. After how many minutes they will meet again? At initially they are at the same point, but when they will start their walking, when they will meet, the question is asking. I would change the question. I would say that at what time, meaning what least time they will meet again. Least time. So how to find after how many minutes they will meet it again? So you have to go with the lowest common multiple. Lowest common multiple, meaning you have to go with the LCM of 18 and 12. This will be a required answer. I would say again, Sonia completing one round in 18 minutes, Ravi completing one round in 12 minutes, they will not meet. So what question is asking, at what least time they will meet again? What least time they will meet again, meaning you have to go with least common multiple. That least word is not appearing in a book. You have to consider by yourself. Then you go through 18 and 12 with your so-called prime factorization method. 2 into 3 to power 2 and 2 to power 2 into 3. Go with LCM, guys. Take 2 as a highest power, take 3 as the highest power. This is 36, meaning after 36 minutes they will meet again. So that's enough for the day, student. Now you do practice of exercise 1.2, the important exercise 1.3 with some important example. We will discuss it tomorrow. And doubts, please ask me on my personal WhatsApp number. Thank you.